Bonjour mesdames et messieurs. In this video, I want to show you a really cool trick to sharpen the right way you photo. There is a huge mistake that I see a lot of photographers doing where they over sharpen globally their photo. This is killing incredible photos. Every Wednesday, I coach dozens of photographers and I see this mistake coming up almost all the time. That's why I had the idea to make this video. I'm going to show you a three-step formula to locally sharpen your photos. It's gonna take your drama to the next level. It's a little trick, but I use it on every photo that I sell out to my galleries. This is something that I see a lot of people not doing. So let's do it, follow me, you will see. Simple, but amazing. Okay, so I will show you the three simple steps using this photo of Big Sur that I shot years ago. It's one of my favorite, photo of this area. This is called, I think, the Julia Pfeiffer Beach. Beautiful beach. It's like a little cove and you have a little waterfall there, which is really cool. So you see what I see a lot of people doing, and because I have a live coaching every Wednesday where I coach other people and they're retouching, and I see so many people doing this. They have, well, worse is when it takes texture and clarity all the way. So the whole photo looks like super over sharpened. It's like, it's in your face details. But I see a lot of people doing that. And I can tell you from working with my galleries, that's not the way to go. I also see people not using clarity. What they do is just boost the texture and they also like boost the sharpen like this. I don't know if you can see it, but it's like everything is super sharp on the photo. I don't know on the video if you can see it, but you know, even if they don't add the texture or the clarity, over sharpening just looks so fake, you know. You're gonna ruin, I've seen so many beautiful photos being ruined by that. So I'm gonna show you three simple steps. It's very short, you'll understand the concept. And I wanna show this to you on this photo of Big Sur, because Big Sur is an amazing area. This is Julia Pfeiffer Beach. I love the cove, I love the waterfall that's there. It's just, wow, it's an incredible place. And the time that I was there, I had just this incredible sunset. It's really one of my favorite landscapes. I wanted to share this with you. So, okay, this is what I do. Step number one is I always look what ISO I shot the photo on. So you see in this case, it was ISO 200. So when it's ISO 100, ISO 200, what I do is I go here at sharpening, first at noise reduction. And usually anything that's above 100, I would, you know, because it's 200, I would probably go like to about 15 of noise reduction, because 200 ISO is going to bring about noise. This was an old, this was, I think, shot with my Canon 5D Mark II. So it was a bit of a noisy camera, great camera for colors, but a little bit noisy. So, I usually do about 50 noise reduction, and I do my famous number, which is I take 100 and I take out what I put in noise reduction. So 15, in this case, I'm going to go up about 85. Voila. So that's good. And now, so that's the first step. So that's like your basic sharpening. The next thing that I do is I make sure that my masking, is at like 50 or 60. You see masking, and I'm holding down the option key so you can see anything which is black is not going to get sharpened. So I don't want to sharpen the sky. I don't want to sharpen anything but where there is detail. So I usually put my masking all the way to 64. And that gives me like a basic sharpening. Like that's just the base, right? But if you want to give an extra punch, here is the magic secret. Please don't tell anybody. I'm just curious. Please share this video. By the way, subscribe to this channel if you're not subscribed yet. I try to make 1 to 2 videos per week. And if you can, smash the like button. That would really help because other people can see the videos. That would be really nice. And leave me a comment. Tell me what you'd like to learn. I need inspiration. Okay, so here we are. So here is the secret. The way I do it is what I call local sharpening. You see, if everything is super sharp in a photo, you're not helping the viewer. So what I usually do is very simple. Once I've got my basic sharpening, I take a brush. And on this one, you can go a little crazy. I'm gonna double click on effect. I'm gonna add some texture, a little bit of clarity, and a little bit of sharpness. So a lot of sharpness, clarity, big brush, and I'm gonna make sure the flow is all the way to 100, and the density all the way to 100, and feather all the way to 100. And then I'm just gonna sharpen these trees here. I'm gonna sharpen here, this rocks here a little bit, maybe here, and voila. Step number three, very simple. So now this is very sharp. Then I'm gonna create a new brush and I'm gonna do the opposite. Minus texture, minus sharpness, minus clarity. And I'm going to unsharp those clouds, for example, or even things which are a little far away, like the sea and the clouds. And now it's going to be hard for you to see. Let me zoom in if you can see it. But you're going to have like very sharp trees and rocks and like a much more fuzzy sky. And that's going to you, when you do your print, that's going to give an additional contrast. You know, you've got contrast of colors like blue against, you know, red and green. That's one contrast. Then you got the contrast of, you know, luminosity, what is really dark with what is really bright. And now you got contrast of what's really sharp and what's a little bit out of focus. And that's the way to get great prints. So remember, step number one, basic sharpening. You do a bit of noise reduction. You deduct that from the number 100. Step number two, you take a brush and you sharpen just the foreground elements with a bit of clarity and sharpening. And then you do the reverse for the back. And voila, simple. By the way, if you want to know how I retouch this photo, how I do my pro retouching, check out this video that I did a couple of weeks ago on the Musée d'Orsay, one of the most famous museums in Paris. Really cool sunset. I show you my whole retouching workflow. The video starts now. Thank you very much.